Pretty low now. He's only down to 100 HP.
Like DJ, in all the games that I see him most successful is Chen. He doesn't even play Chen. He's just he's a Satyr tormentor.
Oh, you know the game with Ohio apparently. Oh, he hits another one. MP. He's gotta be careful. He could be body blocked up here. They're gonna go for the dive to Warcry.
He's got another nuke.
He will be able
though.
To get out, but Ned comes in for the side. And DJ, he picks up the kill, and the crowd goes wild.
Oh, Dubu just got spotted.
Did he just get hit by the tower?
Well, yeah, he really did. What an awkward situation. They are going to be able to get the dust as well as the kick on Ohio. They're going to follow this up with Petty. A stun, and they will be able to finally kill the Broodmother, making it a one for, or two for one, sorry.
Yeah, surprising that that still worked out. And meanwhile at bottom, Rev is going to go down, Ursa being one of the
Mother, obviously. Oh, jump in. They're actually going to try and go on mid one. Body blocked up. No, the face boots allow mid one to be able to stay ahead. They're actually going to turn and kill Dubu as they thought they added the advantage. They get the tier one tower at least for MVP Phoenix, but is Brev actually rotated up to the top lane. Just maybe giving up on bottom. Brev is too dangerous against the phase boots. Ursa, mid lane's gonna be a bit of a dive here. Double Xander Blast comes out. A nice stun from MP though. He threw it onto Net to hit both mid one and DJ on the side. And the rotation from MVP Phoenix. They will successfully get Net here as they should be able to combo up their stun. Another right click. They get it. Dubu's deep inside the tower. Double Xander Blast. They're actually gonna be able to block in Dubu a little bit. There's no way he's getting away from this one. 48 HP, as out of nowhere, 320 damage hits the poor Enchantress. Bottom lane QO is going to be gone on. He does have the dagger out, needs to be able to stay away. And Mushi, but he's been hexed up. Mushi starts going for a QO. He realities around, trying to do this out, but he's going to be going down eventually. The stun hits Mushi. He's underneath the tier 1 tower still, but a nice stun comes out from Net. They'll lose their support. Mushi's trying to juke back in for some sort of TP, but MP's locked on, and that is well worth the trade of the Spectre.
Still, the spec is, I don't know, the spec's the hero that you are trying to protect it all out there.
It's definitely not in the top 10 risks of Mushi.
Yeah.
Okay, well, them not going for it does lead an opportunity now for MVP Phoenix to actually get aggressive with the three-man smoke. They have the haunt ready to go as well. Or no, he's actually going back to base. He's got the mana now. It's coming in soon. They're going to pop the reality, jump in. Moosh is going to be the first target. He's not going to be able to get off and in range. DJ is actually going to be caught by the dagger. They try and slow him down as Zuber rolls on in. They hit the two-man stun, actually slowing down MP. That's going to help as DJ gets enough time to be able to get out. Net, he's got a TP out. He's going to go for it. The stun gets kicked out. Dubu's able to stop it, so it's a two-man gank. But still, that was a lot committed from MVP Phoenix once again, and the Broodmother, she's just going to take a heal from it, or two. But this time around, they play really safe. They feint an attempted kill, force MVP Phoenix to do that, you know, five-man rotation like they're prone to do, and they keep everyone safe.
Yeah, that was a really cool attempt by them. Like the Sven, or the set Ken setback.
Oh, if they can get a lightning proc here from mid one, they can kill Dubu. Never mind. DJ comes in to the side, able to blow him up. Now for Rev's going to be the next target. The imp is snagged by DJ. Not on your belly. They're going to be able to grab for Rev. Stun him up. Fnatic, they found the opening now to really take control of this game. And if they can get the next Roshan, they can complete some objectives.
Aegis and MVP are going to be hard-pressed to take down that Ursa twice.
MP, he's been waiting a long time for this opportunity, and he's finally in a position to go for it. Now the creep wave is in the wrong spot for him. He's still in a position where he can instantly get the stun, God Strength, and kill Net. Gonna go for it now, and yep, he just chops down Net. That was well worth the commitment. Meanwhile, in the top lane, oh, Femi's gonna go down. That's a twofer. Fnatic kill both the Spectre as well as the Vengeful Spirit.
Yeah, they're doing such a good job with the map control right now, and MVP, they're just not really
2k experience.
Hey, they've done a really good job of controlling up the map right now, and they just have to continue to apply pressure to QO.
Oh, Ohio. Good spot out there from Febby. He scouted that one. Coming in soon for mid one. That's going to be super dangerous if they can actually put an Ursa, a Lightning Bear, on the front line. They're going to catch QO here. Febby needs a swap. He gets it off, but it's a short range swap. Still, it's enough for QO to be able to get away. Poor Febby, though, stuck in the jungle against the bear. He's not going to make it out alive. Mushi, meanwhile, is being chased away. He's actually going to lose his ages.
They'll decide to go for it anyways because they know that MVP are not quite at their item timings yet, but Spectre now does have the haunt plus the Radiance, and that might prompt Fnatic to be a little bit more careful here.
Trying to deal with the chin creeps, and he managed to keep most of them alive. Oh, that wasn't the play. That's an awkward one. Mushi's stuck inside the trees in front of the tier 3 tower. Kiwo's going to take this opportunity to go for it. Mid 1 is going to be the first target, though, from MP as well as Juzo. They've already killed the Ursa as well. Jesus, MVP. They're just rolling through Fnatic. Oh, no.
All right, see if the swap's going to go down. If Bebby can hit that missile, and he will. Net throws down the Hex, but it's just a bit too late. Plus, Kiwo is super fast, so. Meanwhile, in the middle lane, Ohio, he's going to go down as well. That is a wipe. We thought it was just going to be a Furion, maybe a Chen as well, but Fnatic misplays turn into a complete wipe, and MVP Phoenix, there's some hexes, it seems, than just winning a fight. They're going to try and push down this middle tier 1 tower, though Fnatic are coming up. It looks like it's about time for MVP Phoenix to retreat.
Yeah. As
Mushi's hungry, he's going to be able to catch Bebby.
They might even get FP over here. As...
Yeah, they are actually trying to control up these heroes pretty nicely. Good kick down on the Sprout. He's going to be able to free up MP. A shot goes down for Ev. He's almost going to be blown up as they drop the jet. Duba's going to go down as well. Fnatic coming back in style. Is there going to be only a fourth one? Hello, Mushi Mushi. Fnatic get everything they want, and we're talking about headspace. How do you...
He wasn't. MVP was trying to, like, say, let's collect our losses. Try to save this one guy. Maybe we can get a quick kill.
Yeah.
Pod's gonna be popped.
No, they can't afford to lose. Oh, they are gonna be able to at least kill Net. They're gonna jump on Mushi here. Mushi turns and fights QO. The stun's come in, though, just in time. QO turns around and finishes off Mushi.
As soon as any team gets any sort of advantage, just like, nope. Gonna strike right back.
Against the Spectre at this point.
Yeah. And Kyo now has the Manta style completed. Another item to
DJ.
Keep him alive.
Nice. They're going to be able to spot out MP here at the follow up. Oh, kick turnaround. Uh-oh. Mid one did not think this engagement was going to go this way. He gets taken out. DJ is probably going to fall as well until the sun comes out. Duba's actually going to lose his life. It's Net trying to right click him down. They're turning around. Duba's hoping to be able to get a kick off, but it's not in time. The Hex gets laid out. MP, he's staying on top of DJ, who's trying desperately to be able to kite him around inside the trees. Duke away. Nope. He's not going to be able to do it. MP stays on top of him on the left hand side. QO, he's already being gone on by Mushi, but Mushi now the turnaround at the end range runs out. QO battling up against Ohio, but he's not going to be able to get him. QO gets away. The buyback here from mid one is also going to be useless as QO TP's back to base. MVP Phoenix, another fight as the momentum of this game is incredibly back and forth.
Yeah, and I think they just got a lot of control back, especially if they can get this tier 2 there in a moment's notice, as mid one does a lot of damage. QO's got to be careful, but this bottom tower push is quite big. Fnatic, they don't have the buyback available on any of their heroes.
Net, he couldn't get off the Glimmer Cape in time, so MP is able to quickly kill him.
They lost their Inertia's Prophet too.
Oh, that was a buyback. This means a full lane of Rags. Mushi's going to be coming up in 5 more seconds, but I don't think he can fight without his disablers. They're going to try for it, though. The TP already forward. They're going to buy back on the line. They have to catch up, but MVP Phoenix, they've already made a clean escape.
Let's see if they can actually get it here.
Mushi would be the big prize, but Net...
Net, he's going to be able to blink away just in time. Glimmer Cape gets laid out. Still, though, he was going to stay on top of DJ. And Net turns around, managed to get off the Hex, but he's not going to be able to save the Chen. The more important target is Mushi.
He gets like swap! Long range swap coming out from Febby. They're going to be able to take out Mushi. Everything MVP Phoenix wanted there was acquired. They'll be able to go straight to the Roshan pit and claim the Aegis.
That must have been like the absolute max.
Something is pretty good, but now they're actually going to try and catch something here with the Spectre. They're easily going to be able to get the Nature's Prophet. He jumps over to Mushi now, who's not going to be able to TP out. Mushi gets caught. That is two cores down. And now, finally, MVP Phoenix have the opportunity to truly go uphill.
Yeah, this Ursa has really started to lose its effectiveness for Fnatic. Like, the timing window of this hero has really kind of faded away. They couldn't afford to lose him this many times over. And MVP, because MVP's lineup is just smooth all across the board. They've got teamfight, late game. And we're seeing that right now because they just don't have the lockdown for all of these cores.
Jump in, MP. He's going to be able to blow up DJ almost immediately. He does have some time to be able to get off his ult, but he's not actually using it. And that means Rev's going to be able to get the kill instead. Mid one's just sitting there trying to beat down MP, but he can't even do that much. Oh no. Mush is trying to catch up. Throws out the in range. He's going to be stalled up. They can't kill this Ven. They're going to turn on the Vivi instead, but it's a pittance as MVP's Phoenix. His core still goes strong. And they call it. MVP Phoenix will take it in a 2-0 as they come back in game number 2 to clean out the series.
And the C Dota boys are going to walk away with the top 4 berth. GG, as Fnatic are knocked out of the tournament, I still think they can hold their heads up high as securing a top six in a tournament like this, knocking out the previous major champions is still a feat, but MVP's journey to continue on as they have to now face EG.
That is probably going to be the toughest